So I know a lot of you guys want to start a YouTube this year, but you don't feel like you have enough money to buy a camera and actually start. But good news, you don't need a camera. You can actually start with just your iPhone. So in this video, I'm gonna teach you guys how you can start YouTube for free with just your iPhone. I actually have a whole playlist called YouTube 101 where I teach you guys YouTube tips to help you on your journey. Let's go and get into the video. Let's go. So the first step to making a YouTube video is lighting. As you can see, I have my iPhone propped up in some boxes. So as you can see here, this is the iPhone recording with no lighting added. This is just the phone. Let's go ahead and open the window and see what it would look like with the window open. So here's the difference with the window open, all natural lighting. As you can see, it's a little bit better. Still probably not the best, but it's doable. And make sure when you're doing it, you're facing towards the window and not your back towards the window, because you want the light to hit your face. But of course, the lighting outside changes, so that's why I recommend getting a ring light. This thing here, as you can see, I have my camera set up on the ring light and whatever, but I really recommend getting a ring light because the lighting outside changes. It's kind of cloudy today, so the lighting's not the best. If it's really sunny, it'll be a little bit better. So that's why I recommend getting a ring light, so you have consistent lighting all year round. Or you can get box lighting, but that's for another day. So right now I am testing the iPhone with no mic. This is how it sounds. Not bad. Let's see what it sounds like with the mic. Alright, so this is the iPhone recording with the microphone. This is with the Movo VRX10 microphone off of Amazon. It's 40 bucks. Probably sounds a little bit louder, a little bit clearer. Hopefully it sounds a little better. We'll see. Alright. Alright, let me go and show you guys the setup that I use for that iPhone recording. As you can see, we have a ring light around the iPhone. And if you come over here, you can see that I have a dongle. And I believe you're going to need this for anything above an iPhone 7. But you have a dongle connected to the iPhone, connected to the mic, which I explained before. This is the Movo VRX10. You don't have to do this, but if you want to, you can get like a mirror or something so you can see yourself. As you see, I can see myself through on the mirror from the iPhone. So if I hit record, I can tell that I'm recording. As you can see, that red thing up there. You don't want to be recording for like 30 minutes and then realize that you never hit record. I've done that with the iPhone because, of course, like I said, it does have a flip screen, so I messed myself up a couple times. But if you have a mirror or anything, you can kind of set up on boxes as I did here and kind of have it pointed down so you can see it at an angle. And there you go. That's all you need. So as you can see on my desk, I have a lot of things that you can pick from. I recommend getting some of these, but let me go and get into what they do and why you should pick them. So the first thing I would recommend getting is a wide angle lens. Now, if you have anything over an 11, you're not gonna really need that because they have a built-in wide angle camera lens. For me, this really helped me. So let me go and show you what that does on the phone. So right now I'm using an iPhone XR with its normal lens, nothing added. As you see, when I extend my arms out, you can't really see past my elbows. It stops like right there. I'm a good distance away. No mic, this is just normal iPhone. Now, if I get the 18 millimeter wide moment lens, you're gonna need the case for this to fit. You're gonna see how much of an impact this makes on it. So let me go ahead and put this on there. All right, so as you can see, it's already a huge difference. As you see, you can see my hands on both sides. I'm in the same exact spot I was the first time. You can see my computer, you can see the roof, you can see a lot. It's just wide angle, it's amazing. As I said, I'm in the same exact spot, edge of my bed. Now, if I get up, I can really move anywhere I want to, but you can still see me. Like right here, you can still see me. I can't even see myself, but I know you can see me. That's how wide this angle is. Now, let me go show you guys what it looks like when you're recording outside with and without the lens. All right, so right now, as you can see, I'm vlogging. This is without the moment lens, no microphone included either. You can kind of hear the wind in the background because I'm using an internal speaker on the phone. As you see, it's not really that wide. You don't get that much of the background. You can just see me. That's not really ideal for vlogging, but this is okay. It doesn't have to be amazing right now. You're just starting off. I'm gonna go ahead at the moment lens and see how good it looks. All right, so this is with the moment lens. As you can see, it's a lot wider of an angle. No microphone still, just the moment lens added. Of course, you can still hear the animals, the wind in the background, because I don't have that dead cat that's on the microphone, that little fluffy part. This is what you kind of get if you want to have a little upgrade. This moment lens costs about 150 bucks, I believe, or 125, I don't remember. But as you can see, very wide angle. My dog's still chilling. Let's go ahead and add the microphone to see how it'll upgrade the experience. All right, so this is with the moment lens and with the microphone. As you can hear, it's probably a lot more clear. You don't hear as much wind in the background. Now, for some people, this isn't enough. If you want to change every option in your video, you know, with the ISO and shutter and all that, then you're going to need ProMovie. So let me go ahead and move over to that and show you what I would do if I was starting, you know, start off vlogging with my iPhone and what I'll get and the ideal setup for me. Let's go ahead and get into that. All right, so ProMovie, as you can see, has a lot going on. Now, you don't have to use this. You can use a normal camera app, which is free, obviously. But if you want to control every aspect of your video, then you're going to need ProMovie. You got a couple options. You got your shutter speed, ISO, white balance, and focus. I'm not going to really get into what they all do, but if you want your video just going to have that motion blurry effect, as you can see on screen, what you're going to have to do is click on the left side, 1080p, and then click 24fps, and click the arrow, the plus arrow. And you want to change your shutter speed to 48 because you want to have it double your FPS. I could change the ISO to 100, and that's how much light is let in. So if I put it to like 100, and now if I just put it, let's put it to 280. If you have a low ISO, it's gonna let in more light. If I go outside right now, it's gonna be very bright. So I'm gonna need a ND filter to kind of like block out the sun, like sunglasses, so that it doesn't let too much light in. So you can have a low shutter speed, so you can kind of have a motion blurry video. Let me show you what I mean by that, because you probably don't understand what I'm talking about. So let me take this outside so you can kind of see what I'm talking about. All right, so as you can see, you can't see pretty much anything. I have the shutter speed at 48, but the ISO is at 150. So as I said before, the lower your ISO, the more light is let in. So when I go outside, as you can see, it's very white. When I put the ND filter on, it's like sunglasses for the camera. So it's not gonna let in as much sun. So let me go ahead and put that on. All right, man, so this is the exact same settings I was using before, same ISO, same shutter. But as you can see, you can actually see. You kind of get that motion blurry effect, as you can see, when you got a shutter speed double the frame rate. So I'm using 24fps, but 48 shutter speed. So it's kind of motion blurry, and it looks amazing. Like, you don't need a camera to have a good video. As you can tell, it's very smooth, and it's kind of that filmic effect that you kind of want. Kind of started going freaking out. Let's go on to the next accessory that would be very useful if you want to become a vlogger or YouTuber, if you want to just start with your iPhone. All right, so as you can see, I have tripods. Now, you don't have to get these exact type of tripods. You can get anything you want. But if you do have an iPhone, you're going to use an iPhone, make sure you get something like this that actually clips onto the phone. You can twist this and it goes up and down and it actually clips to the phone. It's going to have like that at the bottom, so you can actually put other type of tripods on, like this Joby adapter. As you see, it will just twist inside, and you know, it just makes it very easy to record without having to stack up books and do all of that. So I really recommend getting a good tripod if you want to, you know, really get into YouTube. They're very cheap, they're not really that expensive. This one was like 60 or 70. If you want to use a mic, you're gonna obviously need this. If you have anything above a 7, I believe, this just, of course, you know, lets you plug in mics. But let me just go ahead and show you what the iPhone recording looks like with everything that I mentioned in this video, so you can see the difference it makes and why you really don't need a camera. Let's get into it. This would be the ideal setup I would use if I was trying to vlog off my iPhone. Of course, I'm using ProMovie, so I can change every option to kind of get that motion blur effect. So I got the shutter speed to 48 and the FPS to 24. This is what the big YouTubers use to kind of make it a filmic effect that, you know, everybody likes. I'm using a microphone so you don't get the wind in the background, and I'm also using the moment lens to kind of get the wide angle. If you come over here, got my doggy over here. I can zoom in with the zoom, see what she's doing. She's chilling. But yeah, this is what you would get. You know, it's very professional looking. It doesn't look bad. Of course, a camera would be better. It would be more clear, more professional looking. But, you know, if you want to start off cheap as possible, you know, all this, you know, put together would probably be like 200 to 300 bucks. And the cheapest, you know, the cheapest good camera will be like 600, 700. So this is very good starting off if you want to. I'm gonna go inside and hit you guys with the outro. Let's go.
So I showed you guys everything that you would need if you want to start a YouTube with just your iPhone. You know, started with lighting to audio, and a couple of accessories if you wanted to, you know, get into vlogging or whatever. If you guys enjoyed the video, hit that subscribe button, because we're almost at 500 subscribers. Also, hit the notification bell, because I post every Sunday, Tuesday, and Thursday at 3 p.m. Central Standard Time. Tuesday's been reactions, and Sunday and Thursday been lifestyle/commentary videos. I love you guys a lot, and hopefully you learned something in this video. I really make these YouTube 101 videos to help you guys, because I want you guys to grow and be the best that you can be. if you want to be a YouTuber. See you guys Sunday with another lifestyle/commentary video. I love you guys. I'm out. Peace.